can't look like this gift. I'm really sitting there just as if you're thirsty, there's a gift. Off you go.
Here you go. Look at the far end of the runway, and that's right, 3, 2, 1. Go. That used to start the clock for the noise abatement system, and also for switching off the readings. Okay, speed building both sides 100 knots, power is set, we've got the four room lights, so power is set. We get to B1, we've got both hands on the control. B1, rotate, check the 3 degrees a second, good boy, all the way up to 70 degrees, that's a big control, good, keep pulling, then we do ground effect, so those tests are gone. That's it. Very nice indeed, and you will be holding 250 knots anyway. Well, it's 250. Lower the nose a bit, adjust it to allow for the reduced power. And we're trying to do 4,000 feet, 2,500 feet. Lower the nose just a little bit more. So the speed recovers to 250 knots, close to 20. And speed recovering now. Rate of climb sensible. You've only got 500 feet to go, so you can start thinking about leveling off, and the nose attitude you want will be about 70 degrees at 250 knots plus 70 degrees. So I'll set that for you, there you are, 70 degrees. That'll be about right, and that'll hold you at 4,000 feet. We're clear of the mountains now, so you could actually start a right turn now towards Chucky Channel. We've got that slick on these, so here we are. It's a sort of big island which we'll see neatly anyway. And notice the nose dropping in the turn. Yeah, so as you do the turn, that's it, just like a conventional aeroplane, after all the aerodynamic laws is doing so. So you have to pull the stick in the middle of the turn. 25 degrees of bank, that's fine. Yeah, easy about 4,000. The reason why we're at 4,000 is to give us terrain clearance. Actually, it's because there are mountains ahead of us, and it's not accessible.
Yes, it is. I think we need to pass the window.
Am I looking forward to 270?
You don't need to. Oh, yeah, for a heading of 270, yeah, with speed, yeah.
Yeah,
keep turning. It probably will be about that. I've set 270 on the compass. I must admit, I'm doing it visually. We won't be necessarily following that approach that you've got.
I'm doing exactly what you're doing, so I'm watching.
What you tend to find is that when you have an approach bridge, which is the procedure you would use in extremis, it says that say there's no radar, or if air traffic control failed, you would use the approach bridge. Generally speaking, air traffic control will give you radar assistance, which will enable you to short circuit a lot of procedures in an approach bridge. But the approach bridge is still the legal document on which you're then. Sometimes you follow it, sometimes you don't. It depends on the kind of control of the building. But then you have to do that. I have a control. That's probably not a bad heading there, actually. Because past the island, you can actually see Chetland Cock, where the new airfield is, which is beyond the island. And that, of course, they made by this little tunnel. And the soil
is scarred
on the tunnel, became the land reclamation for the UFO. It's a brilliant bit of engineering. That's why I climbed about 1,000 feet to 5,000
feet. Take a lot of soft touch,
so that's right. But don't forget the thing about trims, so take your hands off the controls and see if it's nosing out or nosing down. Pretty good. I think that's pretty good, actually. Leave well alone then. But the trimmer is this little sweet trigger. And it's instinctive. You can push forward, it lowers the nose. If you pull it back, it raises the nose. That's it. That's good. Heading towards Chetland Cock. That's just so, yeah. Once we're through this so-called saddle, that's the depression, which is the long term point. It's really 100 degrees. Which is the it's surprisingly realistic, actually. And when we get to the last part of the approach, we'll be trundling down, and it would have been better to let the co-pilot fly. impacted because it's going to be a right turn on the pipe, so you've not got the best view. But we'll get to a DME position, 2.2 miles, when you start a right turn. Now, because you're going a bit faster than the average,